Hey, health students, digging into chapter 22.2. We've been getting into here just in chapter 22, talking a bit about illegal and illicit drugs. So this is the section where we kind of focus on three different types of drugs. Right now, we're going to talk about marijuana. We're going to talk about other types of inhalants. And we're going to talk about steroids, real briefly about steroids, but enough information for us to get an idea of what it does to the body. So we're going to talk about that, and we're going to go through it rather quick because there's a lot of information here. So be wise to take a quick scan through the text when I'm finished as well, too. So marijuana, inhalants, and steroids. These are three oftenly abused drugs. They can have serious physical and mental side effects. Okay, and again, marijuana, inhalants, and anabolic steroids. Using marijuana has some serious physical and mental, emotional, as well as social and legal consequences. As of right now, it still does have legal consequences. I know that this has been a hot topic for years, if not a couple of decades. When is marijuana going to become legalized? It's already become legalized in some states, and people have talked about, is Minnesota going to be one of those states that marijuana becomes legalized? It still is in many states illegal, but still used for medicinal purposes in many states as well. So marijuana is one of the most widely used, still illegal drugs in most states. Hashish, or hash, is a stronger form of marijuana. It's just a different form and a different version of it. Higher levels of THC.
Marijuana, a plant whose leaves, buds, and flowers are usually smoked for their intoxicating effects.
Okay, marijuana is considered a possible gateway drug, a drug that may lead the user to try other more dangerous drugs. And that's one of the things that we've talked about in lots of different cases is, well, what does marijuana have to do that's any worse than smoking cigarettes? Well, it does impair people mentally and physically. It slows things down, similar to what alcohol is going to do. It works as a depressant. It's going to slow the system down. It's going to slow down the central nervous system. But really what it does is start getting the body used to different types of reactions, and then people utilizing that starts to open up opportunities to get something that's a little bit more heavy for the body and the reaction that people are looking for. And what I mean by opportunities is when people are around drugs, whether it be marijuana or pills or whatever it might be, the more you're around those types of things, the more likely it is that you're going to be around heavier drugs, and people tend to be more curious when they're under the influence of things and more willing to try things. So it does serve as a gateway to more serious drugs. Studies have shown that a teen who uses marijuana is 15 times more likely to use cocaine than a teen who's never used marijuana. The effects of marijuana use can vary from person to person. It can be influenced by a person's mood and surroundings. So if somebody already has certain underlying health conditions, whether they be physical health conditions or mental health conditions, marijuana can affect that in a negative fashion. If somebody deals with depression or anxiety, things of that nature, the use of marijuana can escalate problems. It might, for a moment, suppress some of those problems, but when somebody comes off the effects, similar to alcohol, when somebody comes off the effects of those drugs, those anxieties and depression symptoms become worse. You can see some of the different effects that happen to the body. There's effects to the brain, the mental aspect, there's effects to the heart and lungs, and there's effects to the reproductive aspects of the body. So you can take a peek at that slide. Other risks of marijuana use: increased appetite. People get what are called the munchies. That can lead to weight gain because not only do people get the munchies to just to eat things, they tend to go to things that are more satisfying to the stomach and to the body, and those are usually higher calorie intake, usually higher fats and carbohydrates. So obviously people that are indulging into those things are going to gain some weight. Weakened immune system, decreased initiative or ambition, which means people start to get kind of lazy. Change in hormonal levels, bloodshot eyes, a dry mouth, or cotton mouth. Physical consequences of marijuana, because marijuana is often smoked, users face the same health risks and maybe even to a higher extent as tobacco users. And people sometimes will say, well, it's not proven. It actually is. If you do your facts checking, it's proven that the risks of marijuana are similar to tobacco smoking. Maybe even a little worse. Marijuana smoke contains cancer-causing chemicals. Those are carcinogens. It actually contains more carcinogens than tobacco smoke. Physical consequences continued here. Respiratory system is affected. The immune system is affected. And we talked about the reproductive system being affected. Users often inhale unfiltered smoke. If you think about somebody that smokes cigarettes, that goes through a filter most times. It's not when it's smoked through a joint or a one-hitter or a bong or a bowl. Immune systems. Users may be more susceptible to infections. The immune system is affected in a negative way, so there's a higher probability that people can be infected with other pathogens very easily. So take our situation, for instance, right now with COVID-19. Somebody's got a weakened immune system. It can be even more weakened because of the use of marijuana, which means they could be more susceptible to an infection, to some kind of a virus. Okay, reproductive systems. Users' hormonal levels are affected, which can cause problems when it comes to conceiving children, whether that be male or female. Hormonal releases in the body are affected, and they're not functioning at the same rate or speed that they should be. In fact, things are slowed down. So that could slow down the production of conception if somebody's looking to try to have children. THC is the main psychoactive ingredient in marijuana. Marijuana is stored in the body fat, and traces of it can be present in the blood for a long period of time. So that THC, once somebody has smoked marijuana or has inhaled a product that has THC in it, that stores, like it says, into the body fats and can be there for days, weeks on end before it releases from the system, the body system. Okay, mental and emotional consequences. Marijuana raises levels of brain chemical called dopamine that produces a pleasure feeling called a high. So that's why people indulge in smoking these types of things, because that dopamine is released and it makes people feel pleasure. Okay, when the drug wears off, though, the pleasure sensation stops dramatically. It's not like that pleasure just kind of slowly goes away. It's a quick stop and there's a huge crash. Marijuana users can experience low or slow mental reflexes. It may suffer from sudden feelings of anxiety and paranoia.
And irrational suspiciousness or distrust of others.
Okay, some of the mental consequences or emotional consequences of marijuana use: dizziness, distorted perception, impaired memory, trouble thinking rationally. And obviously there's a problem driving or being behind the wheel of any kind of motor vehicle. It's difficult to operate anything. If you think about what marijuana does to the body, it serves as a depressant, it slows things down, so naturally your reaction time is going to be slower. And that's one of the biggest problems with some of these states that have legalized marijuana, is they don't have a real good solid form of trying to test whether somebody is capable of operating a motor vehicle. Whereas, you know, if you go back to the use of alcohol and somebody's using alcohol, they can do a breathalyzer test. And that breathalyzer test says, okay, you're at a certain blood alcohol concentration. you shouldn't be driving. Or you're not quite to that blood alcohol concentration. Tests say that you should be okay at a certain level. Okay, well, they don't have a way of testing that with marijuana just yet. I would think that they could do a blood test, but they're not going to be, police officers aren't going to be driving around giving under the influence by taking injections from people just yet. So there's problems with that. And Colorado has dealt with some of that already. With them legalizing marijuana, they still haven't figured out how to test for people that are under the influence and I guess manage that. It's dangerous because marijuana interferes with depth perception, increased reaction time, causes sleepiness, impairs judgment, and slows down reflexes. You can see how that would be a problem behind the wheel of a car. Okay, quickly on inhalants. It can cause death of brain cells. So all inhalants are extremely dangerous, and some are labeled poisonous. And any kind of something that somebody inhales, it's not a natural product of some sort. And I know we talk about marijuana as being a natural product sometimes because it's grown, but so much of what marijuana is still synthetic. Very rarely is somebody growing a marijuana plant and using those buds and smoking those buds right from a marijuana plant. There's still some production and synthetic use going on in most cases. But moving on to different types of other types of inhalants, you're talking about people that are sniffing glue, that are huffing paint fumes or gasoline. These have some very serious effects on people. So some inhalants are prescribed by doctors, while other inhalants are there to achieve high. So when you think about inhalants that are prescribed by a doctor, that's something that somebody would inhale, like an albuterol inhaler for somebody's asthma. Okay, those are some types of inhalants that doctors would use. But what we're talking about are other types of things that create fumes, like an aerosol paint can, or somebody that is sniffing a gasoline can for their four-wheeler. Okay, these things create some very serious issues.
Substances whose fumes are sniffed or inhaled to give a mind-altering effect.
Okay, inhaling solvents, aerosols, glues, paints, varnishes, or gasolines. Okay, they can cause liver damage or kidney damage, blindness, brain damage, paralysis, cardiac arrest, and death. These are all things that can happen. Okay. Just different effects. You got it. Somebody might come up with a glossy stare, cough, slurred speech, nosebleed, impaired judgment, fatigue, nausea, and even lack of coordination. Inhalants can be accidentally inhaled when doing household chores. So when you're using different types of cleaning things throughout the house, it's wise to use a face mask. And I'm sure that it's fairly easy to get your hands on a face mask now. A month and a half into our pandemic problem, we had some problems getting a hold of face masks early on. But I think for the most part now, people are able to get a hold of some of those things. When you're cleaning around the house, it's wise to have a face mask on. Those fumes can expose people to some very dangerous chemicals. Okay. A little section here on steroids, and I'm running out of time, but I'd like you to read through causes of steroids here on your own time. Just a little bit about some of the things that steroids can do to the body, and we're specifically talking about anabolic steroids. Anabolic meaning muscle building, and androgenic refers to releasing male characteristics. And so I'll give you the opportunity to take a peek at these slides before you get into doing the assignment. Hope everybody's having a great day. Hope you're enjoying the weather out here lately. It's been fairly nice. But take some time with family and take some time with the outdoors. I know you miss being in school, but take advantage of being physically active outside, and hopefully people get a chance to get out on the lake and get some fishing here soon. Take care.